What's up, ninjas? Welcome to the Gauntlet Course Reveal. Welcome to the first ever course reveal. We are excited to bring you this year's Gauntlet course. Before we jump in, let's cover some basic information. First, we decided to reveal the course because one of our goals at Gauntlet is to create a sustainable environment for professional athletes. Revealing the course will allow those athletes to dedicate their training specifically towards the Gauntlet course. We believe this will produce better results and place more emphasis on high-quality specific training found in other sports. This system will reward athletes willing to put in time and effort to prepare for the Gauntlet. Today, we will only reveal the Pro Male course. All other divisions can expect a modified version of this course. We plan to lower the obstacles, decrease the distance of throws, add obstacles, and generally make the movements more age and skill appropriate, while doing our best to keep those core obstacles in place from the pro competition. One final disclaimer before we dive in, all obstacles are subject to change, and final course may actually vary. This video is intended as a guide to help you prepare for the world's hardest head-to-head obstacle course. It's possible our team may switch around entire obstacles or sections during testing. The final course rules will be posted as our event draws near. Now, without further ado, here's the Pro Male Gauntlet course for our first tournament. Let's start things off with our start platform. Athletes will start on either side of our head-to-head platform. The platform was designed and built by Sen City. Sen City specializes in backyard courses. To have Sen City build your backyard course, DM Ninja to Sen City on Instagram. The course will start with road flares. This obstacle one was manufactured by Stage 4 Designs. For road flares, athletes will race across several barrels. These barrels may lock in or rotate. We may also place them at various angles or distances. This will allow our team to dial the difficulty to an appropriate level. Stage 4 Designs is known for building and rigging high-quality ninja courses for outdoor use. For more on Stage 4, head to www.stage4designs.com. Obstacle number two is Cargo Chaos. This is an in-house obstacle. Our goal with Cargo Chaos is to start your pump early on. The cargo net will be extra taut to allow efficient movement as athletes race to the top of our rig. Once athletes reach the top of Cargo Chaos, they will encounter Wagon Wheel. Wagon Wheel is 4 feet in diameter and will require athletes to time their release as the wheel spins them around. This obstacle is being manufactured by DGS. DGS is a well-known supplier that has obstacles in the majority of ninja gyms. For more information on DGS, head to www.gymsupply.com/ninja. From Wagon Wheel, athletes will dismount to a series of ropes. The ropes will transition the athletes straight into Boardwalk. Boardwalk is a series of rotating and pivoting boards. Athletes will climb up one side, then make a 6 to 9 foot lachet from a pinch grip board before transitioning down the other side. This obstacle is also brought to us from DGS. Athletes strong enough to clear Boardwalk will have the opportunity to rest on one of Gauntlet's only rest platform. The rest platform will also be the start of Rooftop Rumble. This balance obstacle will be shared between both athletes running the course. Athletes will race across the top of a teetering rooftop in an effort to reach the other side of this 15-foot gap. Athletes that make it through Rooftop Rumble will face Flying Fish. Flying Fish will require athletes to bring the bar with them as they make their way through a series of up and out movements. The up gaps are expected to be around 1 to 2 feet, and the out gaps can range from 5 to 7 feet. At the end of Flying Fish, athletes will transition straight into the girder. This horizontal beam will allow athletes the chance to throw their feet up and take an active rest before tackling the final and most grueling obstacles of Gauntlet. Before we move into our final obstacle, we have a very special announcement. Our team has been hard at work designing modifications for younger age groups, and we are excited to announce we will be opening up a single pre-team wave for Gauntlet. Because the wave size is so small and the event has been so popular, we are releasing the registration in only one location to make sure that everyone has a fair chance at registering for the Gauntlet. This Sunday night at 7 p.m., we will drop the registration link for our pre-teen Gauntlet tournament in our Instagram story. Be sure to follow us at National Ninja League and keep an eye out for the launch at 7 p.m. this Sunday night. Now, back to the course.
The final ascent begins with Monstro Climb. Athletes will face a series of beefy campus run throws and dynos. The sequence will even include one reverse catch. Throws range from 5 to 7 feet, and dynos could be as high as 2 to 3 feet up. This obstacle is brought to us by Monstro Holds. Monstro Holds is one of the world leaders when it comes to ninja holds. You can currently find the inch and a half and 2-inch ledges being used for Gauntlet on their website at monstro.ninja. Alright, moving on to our final obstacle. Ninjas strong enough to make their way all the way here will face Heavenly Ascent. Heavenly Ascent is a 60-foot rope climb from the end of Monstro Climb all the way to the top of our 40-foot tower. The race will end when the first athlete manages to reach the buzzer waiting for them at the top of our final climb.
That does it for our course reveal. Be sure to tag us in your training videos. We look forward to seeing you prepare for the world's hardest head-to-head obstacle course. That does it for me. I'll catch you over at the Gauntlet.